with athletes like throwers or young athletes or athletes that are beginners, there has to be some prerequisites that must be developed in order to make the mix of plyometrics and weight training work at maximum efficiency. One important formula to keep in mind is if force equals mass times acceleration, then particular care should be taken with heavy athletes. It's up to the discretion of the coach to address strength in relation to body weight and use safe methods with all athletes when performing these types of exercises. A simple rule of thumb to determine if an athlete is ready for plyometric training is that athlete must be able to squat approximately 1.5 times their body weight. This is important because sometimes if athletes start plyometric training without enough strength, there's a possibility that they may hurt their knees or have other types of joint and ligament type damage. It's also been suggested in the literature that athletes over 100 kilograms or 220 pounds should not perform depth jumps higher than 18 inches. In addition, plyometrics should not be used by athletes with orthopedic injuries. And so if your athlete has had some type of a knee surgery, an ankle surgery, or something like that, it's important to be very careful. With the surgical procedures today, sometimes it's very hard to tell if an athlete has had a surgery or not, so it's good to ask before performing these types of exercises. I think a good way to start out before even attempting plyometrics is have your athletes perform exercises like bodyweight squats. I think these types of exercises are important because you can see what type of flexibility the athlete has in their lower legs, what type of leg strength they have, and I think it's good to see what your athletes look like just moving their body weight before you have them start attempting these types of jumping exercises. Although authorities have placed many qualifications upon the use of plyometric training, ultimately the wisdom of the coach and close observation are prerequisites to using this type of training. Most athletes, including throwers, should not do a lot of much single leg jumping, except maybe if you have a javelin thrower. Obviously, single leg work is great for jumpers, but for heavier athletes, it puts a lot of stress and strain on the lower leg. Written guidelines can never replace visual control by the coach. And what I mean here is you just need to watch your athletes and you need to see if they're using good technique, if they're maintaining good posture. And obviously when you see technique breaking down or if you see the athlete is in any kind of a position that's not going to be strong, then you need to terminate the exercise immediately because these athletes aren't ready to do this. You also don't want to perform plyometrics when the athletes are tired because it also puts them at risk for injury.